The best part of waking up is no caffeine in your cup. Wait, what? That's no fun. Hi everyone, Julia here for D News. I need caffeine in the morning. I'm a total zombie without it. And so are millions of other Americans. Nearly 83% of the population drinks coffee, according to the National Coffee Association. Another survey by Zagat found that most people drink 2.1 cups a day. And that's not a bad thing. Some studies show that coffee can boost your focus and even help prevent diabetes and lower the risk of liver disease. But for some, the caffeine leaves them anxious and jittery. But maybe those people still like the taste, but not the perks. So for them, decaf is the way to go. But how do you decaffeinate coffee? Big shout out to our viewer Jasper Lithgow for asking this very question. Caffeine occurs naturally in some plants, like the cacao tree, coffea plants, and the plant from which tea is made. Like I said, naturally, so any decaffeinating process is pretty unnatural. The first decaffeination process was really unnatural and even a little dangerous. German merchant Ludwig Roselius accidentally discovered that salt water soaked the caffeine out of his coffee beans while they shipped across the ocean. And for some reason, he thought this was a totally good idea. So he tried to recreate it by steaming the beans and using a solvent to remove the caffeine. Unfortunately, he picked benzene, which according to the Center for Disease Control is a known carcinogen and can cause some serious discomfort like stomach pain, dizziness, and even death. So yeah, that's not good. While benzene is no longer used, other chemicals are still used to remove caffeine. The process is a little complicated. Beans are first soaked in water, which opens up the pores in the beans so the caffeine dissolves, but so does some of the flavor. This water then gets treated with a solvent, typically dichloromethane or ethyl acetate, for about 10 hours. This separates the caffeine from the flavors. Finally, the mix gets heated to evaporate the solvents and the caffeine. This water then gets returned to the beans so they can re-soak up all the flavors left behind. Typically, this is what that natural is talking about when a package says naturally decaffeinated. I know, it doesn't sound completely natural. But one of the solvents, ethyl acetate, is actually pretty natural. It's found in a lot of fruits. Unfortunately, it's difficult to extract, so most manufacturers use a synthetic version. Another process gets a little fancier. The Swiss water process relies on simple concepts like osmosis and solubility to remove the caffeine. Using water from mountains in British Columbia, the beans are bathed in really hot water to draw out the caffeine, which is then drawn through a charcoal filter, which catches the large caffeine molecules, but not the other good things you'd want to stay in the bean, like the flavor. So then that water is returned to the beans to put the flavor back in. But these are indirect ways of removing caffeine. The solvents never touch the beans. A more direct way uses CO2. After the beans are soaked in water, they're placed in a stainless steel container called an extraction vessel. Liquid CO2 is then forced into the beans at enormous pressure, at 1,000 pounds per inch. The CO2 draws out the caffeine, but leaves flavors behind. While decaf might seem weird and kind of pointless, some studies show it still retains the health benefits. I mean, decaf still has caffeine in it. One study published in the Journal of Analytical Toxicology found that most major brands have around 8.6 milligrams to 13.9 milligrams of caffeine, compared to a normal cup of coffee, which has around 85 milligrams. One study published in the Journal of Nutritional Neuroscience found that a cup of decaf might help the way the brain metabolizes energy. It could also prove useful for helping prevent and treat decline from diabetes or aging. So no matter what your coffee style, there's no doubt caffeine packs a punch. Trace explains exactly what caffeine does to you in this video right here.
The funny thing here is caffeine withdrawal is something anyone who drinks a lot of coffee has experienced. When they come down off of their caffeine high, heavy users usually experience headaches, fatigue, difficulty concentrating, and even a depressed mood.
How much coffee do you drink? Would you do decaf? Let us know down in the comments below. Or if you have any other questions about the science of food, leave those too. We could answer those in a future video. And please like and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss a single D News episode. Thanks for watching.